हेलो एवरीवन, आई शेफ संतोष मालकोटी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट चित्तकार स्कूल ऑफ हॉस्पिटैलिटी, पंजाब कैंपस, वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस सेशन। इन प्रीवियस सेशंस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट शाकुत्री प्रोडक्ट विच इज कॉल्ड एज बेकन, एंड इन टुडे सेशन यू आर अगेन गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट अ यूनिक शाकुत्री प्रोडक्ट विच इज कॉल्ड एज गैलेंटीन। इट इज वन ऑफ द मीडियम फॉर अ शेफ टू शोकेस हिज और हर स्किल, artistic sense and the knowledge. By the end of the session, you will be able to explain the term galantine, elaborate the steps involved in the making of a galantine, identify types of galantine. So let's start. Galantine, by classical definition, is deboned poultry including rabbit and sometimes game, which is stuffed with force meat. Most of the food historians believe the culinary term galantine comes from the French word galine, meaning chicken, and is related to modern Spanish word for chicken, galina. In French cuisine, galantine is a dish of deboned stuffed meat, most commonly poultry or fish, that is poached and served cold, coated with aspic. Galantines are often stuffed with forcemeat and pressed into a cylindrical shape. In other words, we can say that galantine is a boned poultry or game animal stuffed with forcemeat. Modern galantines are more often rolled into an even elongated shape resembling a thick sausage. The meat of the poultry or game may be left attached to the skin in its natural position. Poultry or game may also be skinned first, and the prime pieces such as the breast used for the inlays. Once assembled, the galantine is poached and left to cool in a rich stock which is made up of the bones of the animal which has been used. Once it is cooled, it can be served sliced with appropriate garnishes. Preparation of galantine. The steps involved in the preparation of galantine can be categorized into four categories. First, pre-preparation, which is followed by assembling, then cooking, and the last one is presentation. In pre-preparation, the bird is first cleaned, dressed, washed, and singed. The wings are removed, and which is reserved for the stock. Skin the bird, remove the meat from the bones, then marinate the breast meat and skin for 3 hours with brandy, white wine, curing salt, and seasonings. During this time, you can prepare the stock with the bones, and meanwhile, you can prepare the force meat also. Now, we have to start with the second stage, that is assembling the galantine. Assembling the galantine is simply a matter of placing and rolling. For this, you need to dampen a piece of cheesecloth and spread it on a work table. Dust the skin slightly with a pinch of dry gelatin and salt and pepper. Spread the forcemeat on the skin. Place the marinated chicken breast lengthwise on top of the forcemeat. Using the cheesecloth, roll the galantine. Make a snug roll free of any large wrinkles in the cheesecloth. Gather the cheesecloth at one end of the roll and tie like a toffee. Do the same with other end also. Now your galantine has been shaped. Now we have to cook it. For cooking, we need to place the galantine in a big brazier, cover with the prepared stock, and place on the range. Now bring the temperature of the stock up to 190 degrees Fahrenheit. Poach the galantine till the internal temperature reaches up to 155 degrees Fahrenheit. Refrigerate the galantine overnight in the same stock. Now the galantine has been cooked. Now it can be presented. Traditionally, the galantines are sliced and served with small cubes of delicate aspic. In this slide, we can understand the steps involved in the preparation of galantine with the help of pictures. First, clean the chicken. Then make a slit at the back of the chicken. Debone the chicken. Now, deboned chicken is being flattened Then place the stuffing in the center of the chicken. Roll the chicken with plastic wrap or cheesecloth. Secure the roll with a foil paper. Cook and then chill. Now the galantine is ready and can be sliced and served with appropriate garnish. Galantines are basically of two kinds. First, ballotine. Second, dodine. The terms galantine and ballotine are often confused. Both are similarly prepared, but they are cooked and served differently. The ballotine is also boneless meat that is stuffed and rolled into a ballot or bundle. Like the galantine, they are also poached but may also be baked or braised in their skins and served as entrees, hot entrees also. This is the smaller relative of galantine. It is an excellent method for using the leg portion of poultry when the breasts have been used in some other preparation. The legs are deboned, leaving the meat and the skin intact. Forcemeat or any other mince is stuffed into the pocket and then the pocket is carefully sealed. The ballotine is normally roasted or braised. It can be glazed with aspic or coated with short froid sauce and can be served cold or hot. This slide explains the various steps involved in the preparation of ballotine with the help of pictures. First, we need to clean the chicken leg. We have to debone it. We need to remove the excess fat. Then it is stuffed using forcemeat. Then the leg is shaped using a cheesecloth or plastic wrap. And then the cooking process is followed. It can be either baked or it can be either braised. Once it is cooked, it can be sliced and served with appropriate garnishes. Dodine. Dodine is similar to ballotine, usually prepared with the legs of duck or goose, and is roasted instead of being poached, and it is always served hot. This is all in the session, and in the upcoming session you will learn about mousse and mousseline, which is again one of the very important component in charcuterie products. Thanks for watching. Stay safe.